Hello everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel Easy Mathematics. In our previous lecture, we discussed what is sequence and series and what is the arithmetic progression. In this lecture, we discuss in details what is the arithmetic progression and how we solve the different type of problems under this arithmetic progression. So first of all, the definition for arithmetic progression, we can say a sequence a1, a2, a3, an, in this way if it is goes for infinity, is called arithmetic progression, in short AP, if an plus 1 is equals to an plus t, where n belongs to the natural number n, where a1 is the first term and d is the common difference of AP. I hope it is the nth term or the general term for this sequence should be then an is equals to a1 plus n minus 1 into d. If d is the common difference and these are the terms, common difference means in between any two consecutive numbers there is the same difference exists. So that from here we can say that a1, if you know, then a1 plus d is a2, a2 plus d is a3, a3 plus d is a4, and likewise it will continue, and that is written here. Now if you want to know the nth term, then nth term means from a1 to a3 the distance is 2d, a1 to a4 the distance is 3d, similarly a1 to an the distance is n minus 1d. So that if you want to find out an, then it should be a1 plus n minus 1d. So if we want to understand this one in the graphical manner, then if these are the points or these are the numbers of the sequence, and here the points are a1, a2, a3, in this way it will, and the difference between any two consecutive numbers are d, then just look, if we want to reach over here, then it is a1 plus all those d's which requires to reach up to an. So that is generates this formula. So this one is the formula for the general term. For n is equals to 1, 2, 3, whatever you put, accordingly you will get that particular term. If we substitute here n is equals to 1, then we will get the first term, that is a1, because 1 minus 1 is 0 and you will get a1. If we substitute n is equals to 2, then we will get a1 plus d. Likewise, all the terms we will get. So this is our general term. So with respect to that, we can write any arithmetic progression in the form of a, a plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d, in this way, and the nth term should be a, n minus 1d, where a is the first term, d is the common difference. So from here, if we add all those, terms, then we will get the respective series of arithmetic progression. So if we add all these, then what should be the sum? That sum is denoted by Sn, and its value we will find as n by 2. If n number of terms are there in the AP, then the sum is n by 2 into the first term plus last term. The first term is a, and the last term, if there are total n number of terms, then last term should be a plus n minus 1 into d. So that Sn we will find out as first term plus last term into n by 2. So first term is a and the last term is a plus n minus d, so that we will find out n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. If you want to know how this proof we will find out, so for that, observe here. Sn we know it is the series a plus d plus a plus 2d plus, in this way it is nth term is a plus n minus 1d. If the same series we write in reverse order, that means Sn only, if we write from this side first, that means this is the nth term, this is n minus 1 term, this is n minus 2nd term. So in this way, if we write in the reverse order, then we will find out the same series written in the two different manner, one from the left and another from the right it is written. After that, if we add both of them, then we will find out 2 into Sn, double sum, is equals to here a plus n minus 1d. What does it imply? That it is 2a plus n minus 1d. Again, if we add these two, then it is 2a plus here n minus 2 into d plus d, means it is n minus 1d. Again, if we add these two, then we will find out 2a plus n minus 1d. In this way, all the terms we will find out like this one. Here, n such terms are there. So that n such terms are there, so that we can write n into 2a plus n minus 1d. And we will find out then 2 into Sn is equals to n into 2a plus n minus 1d. Hence, Sn is equals to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1d, which is our summation or the Sn of the given AP, arithmetic progression, where the AP have the numbers a plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d, like that. Now, there are few important properties of this arithmetic progression. So, the first property is the nth term is equals to an plus b. If the nth term is equals to an plus b in this format, then the series so formed is an arithmetic progression or AP, where the common difference is the a, that is the first term, into the coefficient of n. So, if any expression of this one an plus b, then we can say if it denotes the nth term of a series, then it should be forming an arithmetic progression, and its common difference should be the coefficient of n. Likewise, if Sn is equals to an square plus bn plus c, this type, then the series forming an AP, and in this case, the common difference d directly we can find out from here, and that common difference should be 2a, that is twice the coefficient of n square term. Understand? If the expression for the nth term is an plus b type, then it is forming an AP, and the common difference d is the coefficient of n. If the Sn, that is the summation of these terms, are given, that is in the form of an square plus bn plus c, then we can say this one forming an AP, and its common difference, that the AP having the common difference d, whose value is the twice the coefficient of n square. I hope you get this one. So now, after this one, I am giving you this property 6 number. It is written that Sn minus 1 is equal to Tn. What does it mean? If the first n term's sum is Sn, and first n minus 1th number sum is Sn minus 1, and if we subtract these two, then we will find out the nth term. So, with respect to these three properties, let us have an example. So, if for an AP, it is given that Sn is equals to Pn plus Qn square, where P and Q are the constants. Then find the common difference for this given AP. So the common difference is very simple. Here n square, its coefficient is Q. So the difference, common difference D is 2 into the coefficient of n square. So coefficient of n square is Q. So the D, common difference, is equals to 2Q. And if you want to find out the nth term from here, then Sn is given from here. Easily you can find out Sn minus 1 just by replacing n by n minus 1. Then subtract these two and you will find out the an. And it is very obvious that d is this one, so that you can find out it very easily. Let us check one more example. Let the sum of the first n terms of an AP, A1, A2, A3, in this way, this series, this AP is given as 50n plus n into n minus 7 by 2 into A, where A is a constant. If D is the common difference of this AP, then you should find out the order pair D, A50. Very simple. Sn is given. You are supposed to find out D and the 58th term. So, initially Sn is given. So, we just resettle it as 50n plus, if we just divide it, then we will find out n square a by 2n square minus 7a by 2 into n. Now, from here it is obvious, I hope you can say that what should be the d value. D value is the coefficient of n square, and it should be multiplied by 2. So, it is a by 2 is its coefficient, into 2 means a should be the common difference d. So, that we will write down later on. Before that, if our requirement is to find out an, then an should be sn minus sn minus 1. So given sn, here it is the first sn, then in this one we substitute, instead of n it is n minus 1, then we will find out this one. Now if we subtract these two and simplify, then we will find out this one as 50 plus n minus 4 into a. Now it is the requirement a50. That means instead of n we should substitute 50, so that we will find out a50 is equals to 50 plus 50 minus 4 into a. So it is 50 plus 46 a, which is our answer for an, and obviously for d it should be a. Now for the previous question, I am giving you a different approach. So different approach means we know what is our nth term, that is an, what is our summation of nth term, that is sn, and what is d, what is the first term. Now if for any question sn is given and your requirement is to find out an and d like the previous question, then there is a second method also. This method is quite easy, and this method is basically used in the competitive examinations. So what to do? Sn is given here, this one, and our requirement is to find out an and d. So at first, whatever be the Sn is given, we should take the derivative of Sn with respect to n, just simple derivative. So if we take the derivative of Sn, then we will find out here it is given qn squared. So its derivative with respect to n should be 2 into q into n. So this one. Now pn is given, so its derivative is p only. So after getting the derivative for an, what to do? We just write down the entire thing. That means the derivative, the 2qn plus p. With this p, we should subtract the coefficient of n square in Sn. In Sn, the coefficient of n square is q. So that what we will do? For an, we write 2qn plus p minus q. So this one is your an. You may calculate. You know the formula. You just substitute and you can calculate an in a different way also. So from there, you just compare with this one. You will find out both are same. And for d, it is, you know, that is twice the coefficient of n square. So the n square, its coefficient is q. So the common difference is 2 into q. Very obvious. Not only that, from an also you can find out the common difference. For n, its coefficient directly gives us the common difference d. So d is equals to 2q. From here also we can say what is the common difference. If an, this expression is given, then also you can directly say what is the common difference. If Sn is given, then also you can directly say that what is the common difference. So if you can understand this method, then let me give you a few questions. So the first question is here, if find A7 and D from the AP where Sn is n square minus 2n. So now if we take the derivative of this one, then it is 2n minus 2. So that an should be what? It is 2n minus 2 minus of the coefficient of n square. Its coefficient is 1, so it is minus 1, so it is 2n minus 3. This is your an. So if your requirement is a7, then instead of n substitute 7. That is simple. So if you substitute, then you will find out 11. And d is what? That is definitely, it is the coefficient of this one, that is 2. Or you can find out from here also. So here the coefficient is 1. N square for its coefficient 1 and its double is 2. Hence the d value is 2 here. Now one more example of that type. So for AP, Sn is given this one. So look, this example already we have done. We have calculated A50 and d from the first method. If we apply this method here, then what be the answer? We will find out. So initially, just simply we just write Sn in this format, just simplifying in this form. After that, take the derivative of this one, so that we now directly can write an. So an is what? The derivative of this one means it is a into n, then it is 50, then minus of 7a by 2. So this one, and now minus the coefficient of this one n square, so it is a by 2. If we simplify, then we will find out this one is 50 plus 46a, which is the exactly same as if we will get from the previous method. And very obvious, the d is the coefficient. You can take from here also, that is from an, this is the a, or from sn, that is a by 2 into 2, that is a. Now one problem for your doing, that means here the given problem is
For an AP, SN is equals to 3N square plus 5N, and you are given that AM, the mth term, is equals to 164. Find the value of M, the same type of problem, and I hope you can able to solve this one. If you can solve this one, then write the answer in the comment box. I am very much eager to see your answer. I hope you all of you can able to solve this one. Now the next property is, if for an AP sum of P term is equals to Q, sum of Q term is equals to P, then the sum of P plus Q term is P plus Q. What is it? If for an AP sum of P term is Q, sum of Q term is P, then sum of P plus Q term is P plus Q. One more property is what? That is, if for an AP Pth term is equals to Q and Qth term is equals to P, then the mth term is P plus Q minus M. These are the some tricks also you can say to solve the different questions of AP. So for example, if in an AP T64 is given 13 and T13 is given 64, then find T101. So 101th term can be find out if this one is given. That means TP is equals to Q and TQ is equals to P, then TR we know it is Q plus P minus R. Here it is 13 plus 64 minus 101. So that T101 is equals to minus of 24. I hope it is so very simple. Now, few more properties. So the first is sum and differences of corresponding terms of two APs will form an AP. If we add something to all the terms, add something means add the same thing with all the terms of an AP, or we subtract, or we multiply, or we divide, then whatever the new series we will find out, these all are in AP. So for example, if we have this one, so these are the three numbers given and these are in AP. And the question is, among these three sets, which is in AP if these are in AP? So here this one given that these three numbers are in AP. So if we add with these three numbers 2, then it still remains an AP. After adding 2, if we simplify, then we will find out here it is all same. That is A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C. So this is again in AP. Now we divide this entire these three terms by A plus B plus C. So after that division also, again it remains in AP. So after the division, when we simplify, we will find out it is 1 by A, 1 by B, 1 by C. So that is also in AP. So that among these three options, we can say that the option C is correct option. So hence the answer. Now few more properties. So the sum of infinite terms of an AP should be what? If your AP series goes to infinity, that means if it is not a finite one, if it is goes to infinity, that means suppose it is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, if this is gone for infinity, then what happens? Then its value should be plus infinity if the common difference is greater than 0, and it should be minus infinity if its common difference is less than 0. Now if another property is, if for two AP series are there and it is given that the nth term for the first series and nth term for the second series are in this ratio, then from here directly we can find out the ratio between the summation of nth term for first series and the summation of nth term for the second series just by replacing n by n plus 1 by 2. Similarly, if the reverse is given, that means the ratio of Sn and Sn dashed is given, then we can find out Tn and Tn dashed. Here n should be replaced by 2n minus 1. So for that property also, we have few examples. So just have a look. So for the two different APs where An and An dashed are the respective nth terms and Sn and Sn dashed are the respective sum of the series, then we can find out that Sn by Sn dashed, this ratio can be converted into An An dashed by replacing n by n 2n minus 1. And if this one is given and you want to convert it into the Sn by Sn dash, then you should replace the n by n plus 1 by 2. So this one, if you can remember, then this conversion becomes much more easier. So for example, if this one is the given sum, if the ratio of the sums of n terms of two APs are 3n plus 8 each to 7n plus 15, then find out A12 is to A12 test. That is the 12th term, its ratio for both the series. It is given Sn and Sn dashed. This is the ratio. Our requirement is to find out An and An dashed. So very simple, we should replace this n by 2n minus 1. That's why here if we replace it by that, then this is the replaced value. Now n value is specified as 12. So that instead of n, when we substitute 12, then we will find out this one. So which is the required ratio for A12 by A12 test. Likewise, one more sum. If the reverse is given, that means the ratio between the nth terms are given and our requirement is to find out S49 by S49 dashed. So here S49 by S49 dashed, directly we just replace n by n plus 1 by 2. So by this replacement we will find out this ratio as 58 by 22. Now one more example, but this one is for your solution. You should solve this question by yourself. Here given Sn by Sn dashed is 5n plus 4 divided by 9n plus 6. So you should find out A18 divided by A18 dashed. I hope you can find out it very easily because you can understand how to do this one. So that's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed a lot. And this is not all about AP, but these are the important aspects of AP. The main thing of AP is left, that is the arithmetic mean of arithmetic progression. That we will discuss after discussing the GP and HP, because there is a relationship between the AM, GM and HM. That means arithmetic mean, harmonic mean and geometric mean. So at first we should learn the AP, GP and HP. After that we go for the AM, GM, HM. So that's all for today. Have a nice day. I hope you liked the video. Have a nice day and thank you all.